Hi students, I welcome to all of you to this session of fluid mechanics. Dear students, you know that we are going to discuss just few classes. We have taken the lecture related to flow through pipe. So today we will be going to discuss about the flow through pipe, the loss due to contraction of pipe. So this is me, Dhiraj Mondol, Assistant Professor, JIS College of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering Department. This is my YouTube channel, DM Study Center. You can join here, you can subscribe my channel and press the bell icon to get all the notification. This is the link. All PDF and notes you can get in my Telegram channel, DM Study Center Official. Dhiraj Mondol, this is my Facebook page and email ID. You have to submit all the assignment in this email ID and you can connect me here also. Any kind of query you can mail me, okay? And this is my phone number or WhatsApp number. You can contact me in case if you want to join JIS College of Engineering Mechanical Engineering Department, you can call me here, okay? I will let you know what is the right information. And if you want to visit our college, this is our college, JIS College of Engineering. Admission is open for 2020. Most welcome to JIS College of Engineering. In case of any doubt, you can call this number also. This is the admission cell number, okay? Any help you can ask here. You know that JIS College of Engineering is first private engineering college according to the India Today ranking 2020, and it is also NIRF rank, NAC accredited college, AICT approval, NIRF rank, WBUT, that is your MACAUT, and UGC accredited. Then the mechanical engineering department is your NBA tier 1 accredited college, which is very very important for mechanical student, because if a department is NBA accredited, then there are lot of opportunity may get. A student can get lot of opportunity for higher studies in abroad or some job perspective, okay? So it is very very important. And if you want to join here, you can contact this number. This is the contact number of our HOD, Sir Dr. Sandeep Ghosh, okay? And this is the phone number of admission cell, you can say. Now today we are going to discuss about the flow through pipe. You know that last few classes we have taken what is the loss of energy, what is major loss, what is minor loss, also discuss some numerical, also we have solved minor loss. In case of minor loss, we have seen loss of head due to sudden enlargement. Today we will be discussing about the loss of head due to sudden contraction, loss of head at the entrance of the pipe, loss of head at the exit of the pipe, loss of head to an obstruction in the pipe, loss of head to bend in pipe, loss of head in various pipe fitting. So these will be discussed today. So you know that this is your due to enlargement, what is the loss? I have seen that last class that the expression was come like this: H is equal to V1 minus V2 whole square by 2G. What is V1? Velocity of the pipe in section 1, and velocity of the pipe in the section 2, V1 and V2. Okay, so only the it is depending upon the velocity and gravitational acceleration, okay? Now the loss of head due to sudden contraction, you know, let us consider this is a pipe 1, this is your pipe 2. Now suddenly the pipe, the diameter of the pipe is decreased. That means like this. So this is your diameter D1, this is the diameter D2. Due to this contraction, the water is flowing like this. So you can see the water is flowing like this. This is the shape of the water. Okay, now what happened? If this condition appear, now what will happen? You will see that if I am taking one section here, if I am taking one section here and one section here, so what we will see? We will see that in the face section 1 1, there must be some pressure force, that is equal to P1A1. Okay, now in the section 2 there must be another force, that is basically P2A2. Now if the flow of fluid is shaping like this, that the streamline is like this, then we will see that minimum cross sectional area will be seen in the section CC. Am I right? Now at the time of flow, when the fluid is flowing through a pipe, then the minimum or the minimum cross sectional area where you have got, that point is called your pinna contractor. Do you know this? And coefficient of contraction, you know that we have discussed earlier. What is coefficient of contraction? It is the area of the vena contracta by area of the orifice, is called your coefficient of contraction. Okay, so here the CC can be written as area of the part C in the section CC by area A2. Am I right? Because you know that coefficient of contraction is the area of the vena contracta by area of the orifice. So because of this, if this is your small cross sectional area we are getting, so minimum cross sectional area by the actual area, okay, that is your. Okay, so the basically you know that velocity, coefficient of velocity is what? Actual velocity by theoretical velocity. So actual velocity by theoretical velocity. Similarly, what is coefficient of discharge? Actual discharge by theoretical discharge. So here basically actual is your AC and theoretical what we are getting? A2. Am I right? Now if this point is clear, then it will be it will be more easier to understand. Okay, you can see AC is the area of flow at section CC, BC is the velocity of flow at section CC, A2 is equal to area of flow at section 2 2, this is your 2, and V2 is your velocity at section 2 2. AC, this is very very important. AC is a loss of head due to sudden contraction, that I have to find out. Okay, so that you have to find out, that what is the loss of head due to sudden contraction. So AC is equal to actual loss of head due to enlargement from section CC to section 2 2. Can I write this? That AC basically due to contraction, what is the loss? I have to find out. But the AC is your, what we can write? The loss of, here you can see, loss or actual loss of head due to enlargement from CC. Here from CC to 2, there is some enlargement of the pipe. Enlargement, okay. You can see like this. That means this is your pipe. So here you can see the enlargement. So in this formula, that means if I am assuming that it is enlarged here from section CC to 2, then what is the formula? You know that due to enlargement, what is the formula? V1 minus V2 by whole square by 2G. So here V1 means your VC, and V2 is equal to V2 is equal to V2 itself, and by 2G, whole square by 2G. Can I write this? So assuming that the fluid is basically enlarged from CC point to 2 2 point, दैट इज़ वाई फ्रॉम सेक्शन सी सी टू 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 यू कैन सी देयर इज सम एनलार्जमेंट एंड ड्यू टू दैट एनलार्जमेंट वॉट इज द लॉस ऑफ एनर्जी दैट इज इक्वल टू वी सी माइनस वी टू होल स्क्वायर बाई टू जी. ओके वी टू स्क्वायर नाउ इफ आई एम टेकिंग द टेकिंग कॉमन वी टू स्क्वायर बाई टू जी देन वील बी गेटिंग वी टू स्क्वायर बाई टू जी इन टू वी सी बाई वी टू माइनस वन होल स्क्वायर. ओके सिंपल यू हैव टू टेक कॉमन वी टू स्क्वायर बाई टू जी वाई आई एम टेकिंग बिकॉज आई हैव टू टेक दिस बेसिकली दिस रेशियो एंड दिस इज वॉट VC by V2 is what? Basically, we know that continuity equation AC VC is equal to A2 V2. So, here basically, this is your continuity equation. So VC by V2 is equal to A2 by AC and it is nothing but 1 by CC because CC is equal to AC by A2. Already I have discussed. So we can write this one is equal to 1 by CC. So in the next slide you can see AC is equal to V2 square by 2Z into 1 by CC minus 1 whole square. Now take this part is your k. So AC is equal to k into V2 square by 2G. Am I right? So this is the equation of AC. Now what is the value of CC? Let us, if the value of CC is assumed that it is 0.62. Generally the simple way you are just taking this, assuming that value of CC is equal to 0.62, then this K, value of K will be, after putting the value of CC, you can get 0.375. So ultimately the AC is equal to, will be, it will be 0.375 V2 square by 2G. Okay. If the value of CC is not given, then the heat loss due to conduction is taken 0.5 into V2 square by 2G. So simple, very simple, if it is not given, value of CC is not given, then put AC is equal to 0.5 V2 square by 2G. If the value of CC is given 0.62, then it is equal to 0.375 V2 square by 2G. Very very important, it is needed when we are going to solve the numerical. And in case of the enlargement, what we have seen, V1 minus V2 whole square by 2G. Okay. So this is all about the coefficient of contraction 0.5 V2 square by 2G. This formula is very very important. This numerical I have discussed last class. So I am not going to discuss it anymore. This was your homework. I hope you have solved this problem. Now, and I have seen some assignment related to the this last class. So very few assignment I am receiving. Please submit the assignment. Otherwise, it will be useless because if you are not practicing what I am discussing, that means you are lacking. Okay, so basically you have to practice in your home, otherwise it will be useless for you. Okay, lot of materials available in this, in my channel. You can access that that lecture related to engineering mechanics, lecture related to your and material handling, lecture related to quality and reliability engineering, lecture related to fluid mechanics, fluid machinery, refrigeration and air conditioning, constitution of India, and lot of lecture, and these are available. So you can see that lecture. Okay, most welcome to the DM Study Center. Here you can see loss of heat at the entrance of a pipe. when the particular, this is a pipe. Now when the water is entering into the pipe, due to that entrance, and then when it is entering into the pipe, then you will see that there is some energy loss. Why? Because of this entry, there must be maybe some loss of energy because of the obstruction. Now if it is seen, that means this equation you need to know, HI is equal to 0.5 V square by 2G, whatever the velocity, existing velocity square by 2G. So basically this is the loss of energy in which occurs when a liquid enters a pipe which is connected to a large tank or reservoir. This loss is similar to the loss of heat due to sudden contraction. Okay. And the loss depends on the form of entrance. Okay. And for a sharp S entrance, this loss is slightly more than a rounded or bell mounted entrance. In practice, the value of the loss of heat at entrance of a pipe with the sharp cornered entrance is taken 0.5 V square by 2G. Basically, this derivation is not needed. Only you need to remember this equation, 0.5 V square by 2G. So what I have seen, H is equal to, again remember, V1 minus V2 whole square by 2G, HC contraction, 0.5 V2 square by 2G. Then if the value of CC is given 0.62 and 0.375 V2 square by 2G, you can see here again. Okay, this is a formula. And for the entrance HI, it is equal to 0.5 V square by 2G. Now if it is asked that what is the loss of heat at the exit of the pipe, that means this is a pipe end, and at the exit, what is the loss of it? H naught is equal to V square by 2G. Okay. So, this formula, again, you need to remember, nothing to discuss anymore. V square by 2G only, not 0.5. Okay. So, H naught. Now, the loss of heat due to an obstruction in the pipe. If you are observing there is some obstruction inside the pipe, and due to that obstruction, you will see that the velocity of the flow or water will be minimized. Okay. Whenever there is an obstruction in the pipe, the loss of energy takes place due to a reduction of area of the cross section of the pipe at the place where obstruction is present. There is a sudden enlargement of the area of flow beyond the obstruction, due to which we can see some loss of heat. Now let us consider a small a is the area of the obstruction, capital A is the area of the pipe, okay, and B is the velocity of the pipe. So what is the area actually we are getting? A minus A, area of the flow of liquid at section 1. Here you can see capital A minus small a is the area actually the water is flowing. Okay. Now VC is the velocity of the liquid at vena contracta. So where the minimum cross-sectional area we are getting. So here you can see we are assuming that loss of heat due to obstruction is equal to loss of heat due to enlargement from vena contracta to section 2. Dekho, what happened here? Due to that, here you can see like this. Then the water is flowing. So we will experience some vena contracta somewhere, CC point, and this is your. So what is the due to enlargement? VC minus V2 whole square by 2G. assuming where it is absorbing. So Vc minus V whole square by 2g is the due to enlargement the loss. Now the from the continuity equation AC Vc is equal to AV area into velocity. So and CC is equal to any area of the vena contracta by area of the actual area, theoretical area. So that is your A minus A. Okay, so AC by A minus A is equal to CC, coefficient of contraction, because actual area by theoretical area. So theoretical area is your capital A minus small a. Okay, so ultimately what happened here, continuity equation, here you can see continuity equation. Now put the value, you can see CC into VC. What is VC? CC into A1 minus A2. What is this? This is nothing but the AC. And we have got this AC. AC is equal to CC into CC into A minus small a into VC is equal to AV. Because continuity equation is basically conservation of the rate of flow or mass. So mass entering is equal to mass coming out. So VC is equal to AV by CC into A minus small a. So ultimately loss of head loss due to obstruction is equal to VC minus V whole square by 2G. Okay, and it is equal to this formula already. You just put all the value, you will be getting V2 square by 2G A by CC into capital A minus small a minus A minus 1 whole square. So this is the equation. Okay, so this equation you need to know. Again I am telling you this, because of the obstruction V square by 2G capital A by CC into V square by 2G capital A by CC into A minus 1 whole square. So loss due to obstruction, this is all about the losses. Okay, so you need to know the area of the pipe, you need to know the area of the obstruction, you need to know the velocity, you need to know the coefficient of contraction, and gravitational constant you already know. So because by the help of this formula you can find out the what is the loss due to obstruction. Okay, loss of head due to bend in pipe. So if the pipe is like this shape, so due to that bend of the pipe there must be some loss. This is equal to K into V square by 2G. So ultimately V square by 2G is common form. You have to put the coefficient of bend here. K is equal to coefficient of bend, V is equal to velocity of flow, and HB is the loss of head due to bend. Clear? The value of K depends on angle of bend, radius of curvature of bend, diameter of pipe. Next is your to loss of head in various pipe fitting. Okay, so what is the loss of head if pipe fitting means two pipe is fitted together, okay, like this. So what is the loss of head? This is equal to K V square by 2G. Okay, K V square by 2G, where K is what? Coefficient of pipe fitting. So only V square by 2G and multiple with respect to the coefficient of pipe fitting, coefficient of bend and all this. So this is the formula. So I hope it is clear. Now let us solve a numerical number 11.15. Water is flowing through a horizontal pipe of diameter 200 mm at a velocity of 3 m/s. A circular solid plate of diameter 150 mm is placed in the pipe of obstruction, pipe to obstruct the flow. Find the loss of head due to obstruction in the pipe if CC is equal to 0.62. Very, very important. Now, you need to know what is the due to obstruction, what is the loss of it. V square by 2g a by cc into a minus small a minus 1. Do you know this? Whole square or whole, not? This is your whole square or it would not be whole square? Tell me. So you know this is your formula with whole square, na? V square by 2g a by cc into a minus 1 whole square. So ultimately cc value given 0.62. Velocity area is not given, a diameter is given. Velocity is given, diameter is given. So can I find out? Only you have to put the value, the formula. D is given, V is given, area you can find out y by 40 square. Small d is given, so a small area you can find out. Area of the obstruction, y by 40 square. So this is the area. CC also given 0.62. If it is not given, it will be given actually. Okay. And next is your the head loss due to. So, the head loss due to obstruction. Just this is your formula. All the values you know. CC is given. So put all the value, you will be getting 3.311 meter is the correct answer. This is the loss of heat. So this mass of energy will be lost. Clear? Next problem number 11.16. What is right? First of all, go through the problem, pause the video and try to solve the problem. So determine the rate of flow of water through a pipe of diameter 20 centimeter. And length 50 meter. When one end of the pipe is connected to a tank and other end of the pipe is open to the atmosphere, the pipe is horizontal and the height of water in the tank is 4 meter above the center of the pipe. Consider all minor losses and take F is equal to 0.009 in the formula. HF is equal to 4FL V square by 2ZD. Okay, so this is the reservoir. Water surface is your 4 meter from the center of the pipe and the length of the pipe is given, diameter of the pipe is given. You need to find out determine the rate of flow of the water through the pipe. That means discharge you need to find out. So first of all, what are the given? Then first of all, pause the video and try to solve yourself. Then see the solution. So first of all, you see the diameter is given. Or first of all, write down the given data. Diameter is given d 20 centimeter. That is your take it in terms of meter. L is equal to 50. H is equal to that capital head. Okay, H is equal to or potential energy. You can say 4 meter. Coefficient of contraction, friction given 0.009. Velocity, lead velocity. Velocity is not given, na? Okay, so you need to find out the velocity. You need to assume that velocity is V meter per second. Now, by the help of Bernoulli's equation, you can find out the losses due to entrance. There is an entrance and there is a friction. Due to this friction and due to this entrance, there must be some losses. So that losses should have been discussed here by the help of the Bernoulli's equation. By the help of the Bernoulli's equation, you can easily find out the losses due to entrance and due to the friction. Due to the friction, the Darcy, by the help of Darcy-Weisbach principle, you can find out the major loss and entrance is the minor loss. So these two kind of losses you can experience here. Now, applying Bernoulli's equation in between section 1 and section 2 means, let us consider this is your section 1 and this is your section 2. Okay, this is your section 2. So here what I have written Bernoulli's equation. P1 by rho g, that is your pressure head. P1 by rho g plus V1 square by 2g plus Z1 pressure head plus kinetic head plus potential head. इज इक्वल टू पी टू बाई टू जी प्लस वी टू स्क्वायर बाई टू जी प्लस जेड टू प्लस वॉल लॉसेस. सो वॉल लॉसेस हियर यू कैन सी द लॉसेस लॉस ड्यू टू एंट्रेंस व्हेन द वाटर इज फ्लो एंटरिंग इन टू द पाइप बिकॉज ऑफ दैट देयर मस्ट बी सम लॉस एंड दैट लॉस इज कंसिडर्ड एज माइनर लॉस. एंड व्हेन द वाटर और वॉट एवर द लिक्विड इन साइड द पाइप व्हेन इट इज ट्रैवलिंग फ्रॉम पॉइंट ए टू पॉइंट बी because of this distance there must be some frictional loss and that is basically considered at major loss. Okay, now you can see if I am just putting all the value, so pressure head here in the section 1 pressure head is 0 because we are assuming atmospheric pressure. Velocity almost it is negligible, so that is where V1 is square by 2 is 0. Z1 is equal to 4 because you can see here. So in the section here you can see this is your, in this point the only the energy available is your potential energy, that is your 4. Now 0 is again in the atmosphere, it is atmospheric pressure at the outlet of the pipe, again it is 0 P2 by rho g. V2 square by 2g is what? Kinetic head, and you will experience some velocity because by the help of some velocity energy or kinetic head, the water is coming out with a velocity with some kinetic energy. And the Z2 is equal to 0 because this is the datum line. That is why this is 0. This is your 0. Okay, plus HI and HF, this is the loss, major and minor loss. Okay, so after putting all the value, you will be getting HI, you will be getting in terms of HI and HF and V. The value, okay. So HF is equal to what? By the help of Darcy-Weisbach principle, this is the HF. So 4 FLV square by 2GD is the head loss due to friction. So put all the value, F is given, L is given, velocity is not given though. So velocity you just keep it right now as it is, and GD is given, okay. So put the value of HF here in the equation. In the equation, what I have got this equation. So, A 4 is equal to, this is your V square by 2G. V square by 2G means this is your V square by 2G, okay. And HI is equal to 0.5 V square by 2G. Already I have discussed how to find out the loss due to entrance. Next, HF is equal to 4 FL V square by 2G. Already this is discussed. So put all the value, only the unknown is your V here. So V is the velocity in the pipe. Now once you have got velocity, now just put the equation, discharge is equal to area into velocity. Area you know, pi by 4 d square. So already diameter is given. So discharge I can easily find out by the help of this equation. So this is the numerical, and it is very very important. I will expect that you will be getting this numerical in your final exam. So don't take it casual, okay. And all this what I have discussed, that is your assignment. One homework is given, 11.17. It is given as your homework. So this is the end of the video, end of the lecture. I hope it is clear. And next class we will be discussing about the hydraulic gradient and total energy line. So very very important and interesting chapter. Don't miss this class, okay. And this what I have discussed today, this is your assignment. Solve it in your home, write down in the copy, take a snap, or in the PPT presentation you can send me. Where you have to send? You have to send my official mail ID, that is your, here you can see dhiraj.mondol@jscollege.ac.in. Any kind of query related to admission, you can call me here. Most welcome to JS College of Engineering, Mechanical Engineering Department, which is NBA accredited college and first engineering college in West Bengal according to the India Today 2020 ranking. NIRF rank you can see. So all this data is available in the website. You can visit our website for your online application, okay. So admission for 2020 is available right now, and the seat your number is very very limited. You can visit and you can book your seat as soon as possible. Today up to this. Thank you for listening.